What is up, team? Chuckle Traders War Room, and I'm back at you with another video. Guys, this is your Wednesday sit rep, and I got a fantastic video for you. But what I need you to do right now is I need you to hit that like, share, and subscribe button. And I need you guys to come along with me on your trading and investing journey. And check out that description tab, because I got tons of links to all sorts of products and services that TWR has that can offer you guys some great insight to trading and investing and give you an edge. Now, this video is going to cover some of the alerts that we had today. It's going to cover the text message platform alerts, the instant message alerts, the Discord platform alerts. Man, we got truly something for everyone. We're going to look at the little bit of the website. I'm going to give you guys some stock news. I'm going to give you some stock trends. We're going to look at some stock charts, man. This is your one-stop shop, guys. Traders War Room, you don't have to go anywhere else. Now, if that sounds good, then all I got to say to you is follow me and let's go to war together, team. Traders War Room, baby, let's get it right now. Check out some of the products and services that TWR has, and you can view all of them at the website at traderswarroom.com.
In the Traders War Room, warring with the market every day we on Zoom. Never gonna quit, ain't no way we gonna lose. I done made a profit and it's way before noon. Way to go, dude, come and learn how to trade stocks.
At the end, we have upcoming products and services. Market news. All right, so here's your big news, right? We got this huge IPO coming out for ARM, and this is going to be one of the most anticipated IPOs that is coming into the market this year. This has been waiting on the shelf for quite some time, so this got a lot of buzz about it, and it'll be interesting to see what happens with this specifically, because it's dealing with that semiconductor and that chip space. We also got some news about the stock futures, where they're talking about little change, and it's looking at Wall Street kind of eyeing another inflation report tomorrow. We're going to talk a little bit about that. Starbucks guys buzzing a little bit with the CEO stepping down from the coffee chain board. And it's talking about the strikes that are, you know, pretty much going to happen. They're planned out and they're going to happen in the automaker industry. So it'll be interesting to see how that unfolds specifically as it relates to the stocks of those big ones, you know, GM, Ford, and some of the other auto industries as well. Now, I told you I'd give you a little more information about this ARM. So this IPO, it's looking about $51 per share. Obviously, IPOs tend to spike up pretty significantly in their opening. So, you know, I'd be cautious. Probably you may want to catch this on a dip, because a lot of times these will pop and then they'll come down significantly and then they'll start rising back up. Very few IPOs shoot up extremely high and stay up there. Basically, it's a chip design company, and it's ARM priced its long-awaited initial public offering. This is a SoftBank-owned 90% of the company after the offering, and customers of ARM include Apple, Google, NVIDIA, and Samsung, and they all said they're going to be buying shares of the IPO. So that's why I got a lot of buzz, because you got some of the big names in there, some of those Magnificent Seven names that are going to go into this and buy shares on the public market. Talking about those futures, right? So the stock futures oscillated near the flat line Wednesdays as traders prepare for the August PPI, and it's a measure of wholesale inflation. So there wasn't too much change with the CPI. Basically, everyone was kind of expecting the CPI did come in hot, but it was mainly hot because of the energy sector, which was already kind of built into the market. I'll be interested to see how it's digested with the other reports as the week continues on. If I had to guess, I would assume that we probably cool off a little bit in the market because we've ran pretty hard, and we're most likely going to anticipate that we're going to get another rate hike, which should send the market into a little bit of volatility with some people taking some bread off the table in some of the bigger names. You could see the run up into the federal decision, but it'll likely be a lot of broadening with a bunch of, you know, spikes up to the upside and then quick sharp reversals to the downside, and kind of just fluctuating in and out of those top range and bottom range motion. This is a story that interested me because they had on the Capitol Hill today AI was a huge discussion point for a closed meeting where they had a lot of the big wigs that deal with all of the artificial intelligence, and these are the tech giant people. You know, you got like the Amazon guy, you got the Apple guy, you got the Tesla guy, the Google guy, all that stuff. And these are the, you know, the rich and the famous and the people that are basically kind of controlling the artificial intelligence spectrum. And they were all having a closed hearing discussion about, you know, the way forward. And, you know, it's kind of funny listening to Musk talk about it, because he is kind of on this thing like, listen, we need to get our ducks in a row because artificial intelligence could get out of control if we don't handle it, and it could take over the world, basically, which is a complete different side of the house than like Mark Zuckerberg had, because he was talking about we need to make artificial intelligence open source and we need to allow people to utilize it because we need this in the world and stuff. So it's a different kind of context, different people personalities, and a different perception of the artificial intelligence and the way forward with utilizing it in the future of the global economy.
Market trends.
So let's look at some trends. So overall, the market was bearish today. The leader index was the QQQ. Hottest sector was utilities today. Worst sector was real estate. Hottest stock was mRNA. And I told you about that one, man. We made a lot of money on that one today. And the worst stock was CBRE. Here's the S&P heat map, and as you can see, kind of looks like a little Christmas scenario with, you know, Apple kind of taking a little red, some of the big guys being green, but overall, with some of the smaller and mid caps looking a lot of red and stuff like that. That's why it was kind of flat, man. You kind of saw it just hovering between, you know, a top and a bottom, just kind of moving sideways. Here's your industry map, basically utilities, consumer discretionaries leading the way, real estate and energy lagging. Now, energy specifically, I want you to pay attention to energy as we roll into next week. I think this week, energy is probably going to be lagging. However, going into next week, a lot of times energy likes to take a back seat in particular weeks, and then it booms in the next week. So watch energy next week for probably a little bit of a run from a nice little sell-off it's getting this week. I wouldn't be surprised if we get some sort of news on energy over the weekend and energy starts to spike up and we can go ahead and start capitalizing on potentially some over the weekend swing trades or some nice trades starting off the week in the energy sector. Here's that sector rotation, and we've been looking at this for a while. Notice that energy is now kind of meeting up with consumer discretionary. You're starting to see the communication services kind of push up into the mix, kind of from the bottom. And of course, financials is interesting because you're starting to see financials pop a little bit or kind of show some strength. So it'd be interesting to see if we get a nice little surge in financials, because it hasn't really been doing anything. It hasn't been good. It hasn't been bad. It's just kind of been, you know, blah, basically. I'd like to see financials get a little bit of a pop. So that'd be interesting to see if we get a sector rotation of some big money and institutional money into that. Obviously, technology will fluctuate a little bit. We're still seeing it kind of lagging overall. People are taking some bread off the table as they're rotating into some other things that are moving and shaking. Now, this right here is showing you the biggest gainers overall of the most popular stocks. You see mRNA, of course, popping and locking. Amazon had a good day. AMD had a good day. Oracle popping off from its absolute dismal earnings report. So you saw a little bit of a bounce from there, which we thought we would see a little bounce play from such a knee-jerk reaction. So overall, we're looking pretty good on some of these popular big boy plays. You look at the gainers, you got to look at the losers. MMM, man, they have had some trouble. But at this price on Triple M, I like this price. I think this is a buy for shares holding long on Triple M. I think this is a good price for them. Netflix, that was a surprise, man. People were surprised because extremely bullish on Netflix, and it kind of caught people off guard because they were going long, and nope, reversal, 5% to the downside. That definitely got some people going. Dollar General, Schwab, the airlines are sucking right now, so paying attention to Dallas and American Airlines specifically. And we'll get into a couple of these charts when we get into the chart section. insider transactions. I don't add this very much, but every now and then I like to add it, specifically when we get a nice little segment of kind of a 50-50 buy and sell ratio. So you're seeing a lot of these insider buys on GSAT and CG and some of the other ones. So it might be, you know, something to go ahead and take a look at some of the underlying fundamentals, seeing if they got some catalysts going in. Why are people buying these up? And here's the insider selling on the same spectrum as why we want to know why the buyers are buying. We want to know why they're selling too. So why are people selling SPLK? Is it because it sucks, or is it because they're just a normal selling because they haven't sold since the beginning and you got an insider that's finally taking a little bit of profit since, you know, they haven't taken any for, you know, years and stuff. So be interesting digging into it a little bit. SPLK is one I follow, and I'll be looking at that one. MGPI, another one, and KBH is one that I like to follow as well. All right, I like this one here because you guys know I love the penny stocks, all right? Specifically, when we're struggling with those blue chips, I love to get into the penny market. Penny market is fire right now, man. There's a lot of opportunity. Look at that. I mean, you can see the opportunity right there. You know, 17 cents to 28 cents, that's money, guys. That's 10-cent push right there, 28-cent push. Look at that, a 5.91 push on a change. This is good money for penny stocks, guys. You need to get invested in these. They're cheap. You buy yourself a cheap stock. You get 1,000 shares of it. You ride it up 5-10 cents maybe. You cut out and you rinse and repeat, man. It's a good profit making, specifically while you're waiting for the blue chips to come around or you're waiting for your options to mature and get you money off of heading into expiration. Again, I like to look at these top losers because anything that's over a dollar has me interested on potentially a knee-jerk reaction, and I like to look at it for a bounce-type play, like specifically this one, like HOLO, right? Fell 80% today, $8 difference. That got me thinking that, man, this thing probably is sucking somewhere, right? There's something wrong with it fundamentally. Some sort of catalyst went against it, right? But it was probably an over knee-jerk reaction, and we'll probably get some of that percentage back. Now, will we get all that 80% back? Nah. You know, it was $8.52. Nah, we won't get that back. But we could get a dollar, maybe $2 back. And at the price it is right now, like I said, you go in with 1,000 shares, you make back $2 on that. That's money, guys. Any way you look at that, that's money. LGVNR, that's probably looking to get delisted. I mean, it's what, a penny? You know, so some of these are just crap stocks. But the ones that are significantly down and there's really no reason other than maybe some sort of negative news catalyst, look at them and watch them. If you start to see the volume flow into it, don't be afraid to pull the trigger and ride some momentum. Here's your most active, paying attention to some of these weed stocks again. We got the SQs hitting it up, Tesla. We got Grab, Apple, of course. The auto industry's in there. Amazon's been popping a lot. Of course, you got your Spine, you got your Q, and you got your Wee, and you got your AAL. We talked about the airlines. There's some problems with AAL, man. They got some big issues. So definitely watching them probably for some more downward trending. Most volatile, Netflix meets that list because it had such a dramatic shift. We also got some of the other ones. AVGO, of course, is in there. NVDA, Adobe, as it goes into earnings. FSLR, Charter. So there's some big boys in here that we're paying attention to. LRCX, a lot of good ones for some volatility moves, specifically the bigger names. You can definitely make some decent money if you catch your trades correctly. You get the peaks and you ride them down, or you get the dips, you ride them up. You can easily make $1,000 a day off of some of these big boy names. Unusual volume. What we like about unusual volume is it gives us an idea of why is it unusual. You know, some of these stocks are, you know, just trading at, you know, less than a million volume, and all of a sudden they spike up, you know, to like 5 million volume or something like that. You know, why? Is there some sort of news? Is it, you know, a short squeeze? You know, what's going on? Specifically the cheaper ones. We like those because we're able to ride those momentum. You know, like we talked about that earlier, right? That HOLO and some of these other ones. So unusual volume is definitely, we got to pay attention to it, because we got to remember one of the most important aspects of a stock is its price action. And price action of a stock is directly correlated to the volume of trading that is exchanging on the day chart. Just remember that. I put this one in here. This one's an interesting chart. I like this one. This one is unusual option volume. And this one is interesting because it has a lot of the big boy names. You know, you got your Tesla, your Apple, your NVIDIA, Oracle. This one is a good one right here. It's giving you guys your option volume, your price, the one-day change, and your regular volume of the underlying asset. This is a very good chart to utilize specifically because it has all the big boy names that everyone's trading anyways and trying to make some money off of. So this is a good chart to probably snap, save, and utilize this for tomorrow. And here's your unusual volume, or excuse me, unusual options. Why are people putting these options in? What do they know that we don't know? That's what we think when we see unusual options. What is the big money thinking when they're putting in these, you know, orders for these? What is the move that could potentially happen? NVIDIA, you've seen some calls. GM, you got some puts, they're expecting that strike. Verizon puts, they're expecting some downward trending in that particular thing. AMD looking for some puts in that semiconductor area, so it'll be interesting. The airlines looking at puts. Amazon looking at puts. They're expecting to hit resistance, and the DOJ is on that Amazon thing with the Google thing, right? Those antitrust things, all right, looking at hidden resistance, just paying attention to where the big money's flowing, guys. Here's some stocks that are overbought. According to the RSI, they're over 70. We like to use this typically when you're looking for overbought stocks on the RSI. You want to understand why they're overbought. Is it because there is a legit fundamental reason? If so, you're probably looking for bullish continuation because they're overbought. However, if there's no real fundamental reason, it's only a technical reason and maybe a weak catalyst, you're probably looking at a trend reversal sooner than later. That's the whole idea with looking at overbought type of stocks based off the RSI. And same idea here with the RSI 30, oversold. Why are they oversold? Are they sucking? Do they have some sort of fundamental reason to be this low? Or is it just taking bread off the table because they've ran extremely hard and on the daily they're oversold, looking for potentially a bottom position for a bounce play? That's what you're looking at when you look at the RSI 30. You got to dig into the fundamentals anytime you're utilizing the RSI for the bounce type plays. Same thing here with these 52-week highs. Again, is it a good reason why it's at a 52-week high? I was just talking about the Amazon. We're looking at potential rejection from this, not because Amazon sucks, but because Amazon just hit a 52-week high, and does it really have the catalyst currently to keep this thing moving to the upside? I don't think it does. I don't think Amazon has the catalyst currently to keep the momentum going to the top. So most likely, we're going to see rejection from resistance and the pullback to a level where we start to gain support at a new top level, and then we can start building from there. That's the whole idea with the 52-week high. Now, if they got some fantastic news and they just hit the 52-week high, you might be looking at some bullish continuation, which is fantastic. But specifically in this market, anytime you're looking at the 52-week high, you should already have a light bulb in your head thinking reversal sooner than later. And your 52-week lows, I'm not going to bore you with the same spiel I just gave you with the 52-week highs. It's all the same, just in the reverse, man. You're just looking for the rejection from the bottom and a bounce play. Does it really suck? Does it deserve to be down here? If so, we probably got bearish continuation. If not, we're probably looking to get some consolidation from support and probably to bounce up from here. Stocks I like. A true market warrior makes money no matter which direction the market goes. My setup on charts is pretty simple. Blue, red, purple, okay? Purple, battle zone, that's where we're at currently. Blue, that's where the bullish push from the battle zone is at. If we get the price action to the bull side, that's where we're looking for continuation to the upside. If we hit the bear side of the house, red, that's where we're looking for continuation to the downside. All right, so normally I do the Q and SPY, but I'm more interested in the Q because it's moving a little bit more dramatically with the big names in the tech selling off. So I do think that we see a little bit of pressure and we come back down to retest the bottom level. We're starting to form a tower candlestick pattern. And typically what you see with the top tower candlestick is you'll see a downtrending motion. Now, we could easily pop up and retest that 377 first from the battle zone, but I think if we pop up there and if we're unable to hold the level, we most likely will reject that very quickly and we'll head back down towards that 373 and even beyond to the 370. Also, it'll depend on what the PPI has to say. If PPI comes in hot as well, I think the CPI plus the PPI will give individuals a little less comfort in digesting these inflation numbers, and I think we'll start to sell off a little bit more heading into the close of this week. When you look at this chart, you can see why I'm a little bit bearish on it. This has ran absolutely just phenomenal since back in May. It's time for this to come down a little bit. Now, we definitely hit the double top and we pushed up from the double top, but typically that is the breakout to the new level and we see the cool down to make sure that we can indeed hold that upper level. So I think we reject from the battle zone. We come down to retest that 141, 140, see if we can hold. If that level holds, then we can start our little consolidation period and move to the upside from there. However, if we can't hold, most likely this is probably going to come back and retest the 135 area before our next leg to the upside. Inverse cup and handle. I told you guys about this the other day. I told you Apple would be 175, and absolutely we were spot on with that. Now, we got a double bottom. Typically from the double bottom, you'll see the push to the upside. However, Apple is under heavy pressure right now with a lot of analysts downgrading it based off of that Investor Day thing. So I could see us having a little bit more continuation to the downside with us going towards 172, which would be the next level of support after this current level. But I don't see us getting down there without a battle. So I'm expecting probably some bouncing around, a little consolidation before our next leg down if we get it. Look at Netflix, man. Netflix got hammered. Now, typically, I would say we'd look for the bounce play on this, but Netflix is one of those expensive stocks, and this can afford to go down a little bit more. But I do think Netflix is extremely popular. I would wager if we go down, we don't go down without a fight, and it'll be extremely volatile. We'll probably bounce around that 412 to 420 area, and potentially between 420 and 405 will be our little area of range trading that'll happen with Netflix until it decides to pick a direction for continuation, either the rejection from bottom so we can start a bullish upsend or bullish ascend, or we get the bearish continuation to the downside. A nice cheap one for you to get your hands on with some stock shares, FFIE. This one was a penny stock not too long ago. They did like a reverse split, so it's, you know, a little more expensive than you guys are probably used to, but we got a nice cup forming, looking like we're about to break to the upside. So I think this would be a decent little day trade or potentially a swing trade on a nice little penny stock. You probably could go in pretty deep and look for a 2x on here if you got the patience and the time to wait for it. Starbucks looking pretty rough. We got a cup starting to form, but we do got some nice broadening to the downside.
Starbucks is suffering a little bit. I do think we probably lag here a little bit to the downside before we start to find our footing and push to the upside. So I'd be looking for a little bit of a bearish continuation on Starbucks, specifically since their CEO is stepping down and they're probably in limbo a little bit with the next chain of command. And American Airlines, they're having some trouble. We're definitely looking at this. This one, I mean, it's all over the place with some downtrending pressure. Probably a little bit of consolidation here at this level. But if they don't get their act together, we're looking at this heading down towards $11. I mean, it's been there before in the past. It'll get there again. This thing does like to reject from the bottom. So we could see a nice little sharp reversal, but as long as the trending news is still extremely bearish, I would just assume that we get bearish continuation. But I do think that this is a good stock to go ahead and start grabbing up a position in, specifically on these dips. I think if you know, at this price right here, you go in and grab 10 shares, maybe 100 shares, depending on, you know, your cash flow, and you start buying on the dollar cost averaging on the dips, you'd be very happy in about 3 to 5 years. Sava trending down here, consolidating. I like Sava. I think anything below $20 is a buy zone for Sava. I'd be buying shares up all day on Sava. We probably got a little leg to the downside unless we get some bullish catalysts. I saw some other names pop up in the Parkinson and Alzheimer's disease name, so we might see a little bit of spark in these. However, this is buy zone for me. Anything below $20, I'm in on Sava. So I'm dollar cost averaging in my position. Sava is one of my biggest holdings. I'm hoping it pays off by holding long. I've been very patient with this, and you know, basically it's one of my things I'm just waiting on, you know, 3 to 5 years. Hopefully it pays off. Adobe, I'm going to make a bold prediction, okay? I think Adobe runs into earnings, and then I think they have an Oracle type of moment. And when I show you this next chart, you'll kind of grasp what I'm talking about. But I think they run hard, get a little pop, and then I think they underwhelm on earnings, and they drop. And the reason being is because they ran so hard on their artificial intelligence, but I don't think their earnings report is going to reflect anything significantly new, and I don't think that they're going to have anything really more developing on this front with going into, you know, the monetization and stuff like that. So I think that their earnings report is basically going to be in line, but nothing spectacular specifically like it was the last time. And this is the chart exactly. This is the weekly chart. You look back here in May, I mean, it was a $350 stock, and it's all the way up here $200 more. So that's what tells me that we probably are looking at a little downtrending pressure. I would not be surprised after earnings if this thing falls to about 525 before it's all said and done. And we'll probably look to do a lotto trade for the free trade alert tomorrow on our video. So definitely paying attention to it. You guys already know that this is on my radar, and if we start to smell the hints of the bearish juices flowing, you guys already know that I'm going to go in on this one, because this is my plan and I'm giving it to you early, but I'll definitely post it in my video as well tomorrow. TWR alert update. Text message alerts were off and running, and we're pretty fire today. Here was a Google swing trade that we went ahead and trimmed and put a stop loss on. Took it from 53 to 65. Bring that stop loss to 55, and it's risk-free all the way home. If you guys want these text message alerts, that green arrow is showing you, all you got to do is go to the website, tradersworldroom.com/text alerts, and you can sign up today. Let's look at another one. And here's another swing trade. We went ahead and sold Pfizer today, 51 to 81. That's good for $30 on the day. Guys, if you want these fire text message alerts, go to the website, sign up today. I will contact you directly once you sign up and purchase. I will verify your cell phone number, make sure it works. And then once that is done, we're good to go. you'll start getting the alerts via the text message alert bot. Discord platform was popping. You had Shiner over here killing it with Netflix, man, showing you guys how to trade, going both ways on the Netflix trade, absolutely killing it in the live trading room. We have live trading on the Discord platform, bell to bell. One of the perks of being a TWR All Access member on the Discord platform. It's our flagship. You can definitely go to the website and check it out. Here's another trade on Netflix. Took it to the bank, man. These little $20, $30, $50 trades, they add up. Today, his net profit on the live trading was over $1,000, guys. $1,000 per day is life-changing money. You can catch all of that at the live trading room on TWR Discord flagship platform. TLM with a nice trade off of some downtrending pressure on the queue. Went in at 1 on the queue, came out at 127. That's good for $27 profit per contract. Can't complain about that. Take a look at the TWR Snowman riding Netflix down. You saw Shiner riding it on the reversal. Snowman caught this on the downward trending. Look at that entry. 218 rode this all the way to over 8. Man, that is a steak dinner any day of the week. And I don't highlight our instant message platform enough, and I really should, man, because it's a fantastic platform. You guys should really check it out. You can go to the website and look it up. But Jay Bass over there, our manager, he covers the game, man. He is fantastic. Look at this right here, this Q trade right here. Took this from 49 all the way to 76. All you got to do is put that stop loss above break even, and it's risk-free. Fantastic trade right there. And he pushes it all, man. He pushes the Myrna trade. He pushes the challenge trades. I mean, our members on all three of the platforms get absolutely the best TWR has to offer. And it's something for everyone, every style, and every budget, guys. Go to that website, traderswarroom.com. We got something for you over there. And if you're serious about making money, then we are your one-stop shop. $100 to $1,000 per day is possible as a TWR market warrior. So quit wasting money that's not making bank and join TWR today. The link is in the description. Upcoming products and services. Traders War Room is proud to present our hottest new feature, text message alerts, available now on the TWR storefront. If you enjoy trading and investing, you're probably familiar with some of these popular applications. These are all fantastic, but they can become overwhelming and difficult to navigate throughout the day. Add in the stresses of work, life, school, family, and you become frustrated and overwhelmed, missing opportunities. Guys, that's so me.
Yeah, that's me.
This stops right now. Welcome to TWR's text message alerts. It's super simple, too. So we watch the market, and when we see a setup we like, we push an alert like this. You as a subscriber receive this. And don't worry, we give you an exit too, just like this. So for more information, check out our storefront, links in the description. And remember, when you hear this, Traders War Room is making you this. Traders War Room is your one-stop shop. Try our TWR one-to-one mentoring. Does the market have you feeling like this? Or wanting to rip your hair out while you watch your account dwindle? If that's you, then Traders War Room has you covered. Our one-to-ones focus on you as a trader or investor. The Zoom session connects you with a TWR professional. Whether we're covering charts, developing a plan of attack, or being strategic and deep diving on the how, why, and execution of trade plans, TWR one-to-ones will give you the confidence to attack, conquer, destroy, and make the market bend the knee in 2023. Join TWR and bow to no one. Book your session today. The link is in the description or on the website at traderswarroom.com. Let's go to war. Quit wasting money that's not making money and join TWR today. The links are in the description.